I am. I'm very fortunate. I'm lucky I'm a comedian, because otherwise my life would just be a series of undocumented low points. I don't know how you guys do it. Hats off to you, really. I mean, fighting the good fight out there. No, I just try to like make sure I learn the lesson from whatever I get into. Get the lesson out of it, you know. Like I had a very particular low point. It was a few months back, and I was at 7-Eleven buying dinner. And that's not where you get a staple if you're in the vicinity of somebody that loves you. I was not. I was in Los Angeles. Nobody loves anybody down there. Nevertheless, I was there. I think even sadder yet is I knew exactly what I wanted to, because I made a beeline right for that little hot dog aquarium that's on the counter in there. Which it's its own metaphor for sadness, because all those meats, they're all rolling towards you, but they're not gaining any ground. It's just steamy frustration in there. Like, you can almost hear a hot dog. Like, I can see the horizon. We're going to make it. No. And amongst all the tumbling, sweaty meats, there was one lone cheeseburger bite left in there. Which, if you don't know what a cheeseburger bite is, I'm going to tell you. It's a cheeseburger. Sure. But it's shaped like a hot dog. Because 7-Eleven's whole ad campaign right now, I think, is just, fuck it. You're gonna eat it. You're gonna eat it. Are you not gonna eat it? Free cheese. Told you you'd eat it. And I don't know how it came into being, you know, I don't know if there's some weird Dr. Moreau type character in R&D at 7-Eleven that's just trying to mash shitty foods into one another, like, hot dogs will become cheeseburgers, cheeseburgers become hot dogs. Or if somebody dropped an actual cheeseburger onto that perpetual motion machine, and then just the sheer force of time and movement, it acquired the shape of a hot dog. A lot like how broken glass gets smoothed out and jewel-like if the waves crash on it in the sand. Clearly, I've thought about this far too much. But I'm in there, and I'm just pointing it out. I'm excited about it. And the midnight clerk at 7-Eleven comes over, a man who should not have hope left for society. He shouldn't care what anybody does. This guy's off, he's off the grid at this point. Even this guy tried to give me an out. Even he tried to like stop what he was about to see. See, that, like the same like when a blackjack dealer sees somebody that just wasted, they're hitting on 20, and even they can't take it anymore. They're just like. He gave me one of those. He came over, but he put the question on me. Let it be my choice. He just came over. He's like, what are you doing? Look at what you're doing. What are you doing? And I didn't even look up from the plastic. I was just like, I'm a gambler. And he didn't even realize what that meant. But that's where his face just dropped. He didn't even use tongs. Just grabbed it with his hands. Bun, here you go. I didn't eat it as much as I made it disappear like a David Blaine illusion. They came at me, it was like, crumbs, magic hands! Like one fell swoop, meow, debit card, buck 89, shump shump, Chase rewards points! And I had to get out to the sidewalk before I realized what, like, everything that just had. Like, I just ate the same dinner as a homeless person, but I didn't even savor it. I didn't even appreciate it. And that was a low point. That was a Tuesday. And then Wednesday, I got a DUI and I went to jail. For the more poetic of you out there, Whiskey Icarus finally flew a little too close to the sun. And I don't know if you've ever been to jail before, but when you go there, you get to sit on a little bunk bed without your shoelaces, and you get to contemplate your life. You get to say things to yourself like, hey, Kyle, remember when you thought eating that cheeseburger bite was a real low point? It's time to recalibrate your definition of fucking up. They took your belt so you don't hurt yourself. And I'm not trying to make light of drinking and driving. I made a mistake. I screwed up. But understand that there are grades to that crime. There are degrees to drinking and driving. I got my DUI in Los Angeles. I'm from Chicago, where to get a DUI in Chicago, we got some people. You clearly will understand this. You would have to drive through a playground at recess and still fail a field sobriety test. I pulled over on the highway once because even I knew I was too drunk to drive in Chicago. Pulled over, shirt open, gonna take a nap. Keys in the ignition because I like to listen to tunes while I slumber. Woke up with police flashlights shining in my face and them just saying, "Let me see your hands." And my first thing I just blurted out is like, "How'd you guys get in my room?" They let me drive home. Said, "You take this room back to the house that is it a part of." I got my DUI in Los Angeles. Where to get a DUI there? You just have to look like this and be singing classic rock a little too enthusiastically at 1:30 in the morning while going 5 miles an hour over the speed limit. But I learned my lesson, don't drink and drive. Also learned my lesson, don't get your lawyer based off of Yelp reviews. So I go, well, Daryl from Burbank gave him 4 stars, how bad could it be? Daryl also reviewed the coffee at a Jiffy Lube. Also 4 stars. And he doesn't want to praise too much, but he wants to be encouraging. I like his style. Ugh.